My name is William Edward Austin, alias Bill. And when I got in the service, I wanted a choice of where I would be. And as a result, and being a student at Texas Technological College in Lubbock, Texas, I knew I needed something of the background of where I was located. And which way I was headed. I was working on a degree in chemistry, chemical engineering. And I thought I would check out some various things along this line. And I ended up going to a school in Southern California, University of Southern Cal. I really had to have some things done to me to get me ready to go to that school. One thing, I needed a hernia operation. I had been a rough guy that knew what hard work was and was had been working for Fur Number 3 at right across the campus from Lubbock High School. I had gone to a local pastor before I ever started college, checking out things that I liked. And that's how I ended up at Texas Tech, Technological College, that had an engineering school. And I started college there. I was asked by the pastor of the church that I was going to about my background, and he said, "Had you ever thought of being a pastor?" I said, "Yes, I had, but there's some things about the school I was going to that didn't necessarily help me there, because Texas Technological College was very, very distinctly an engineering school." Those are the days when they wanted you to stay in the service division of one of the colleges. And USC was ideal for that, because it had so many colleges. We had nearly every branch of the service in college at USC. We had the weekends were spent on campus also. And I started out in chemistry at USC.
Which branch of the armed forces were you a part of?
In the Navy. I'd chosen the Navy because I thought I would like it, though I had never been to sea. And when I got to California, I got a good, heavy engineering degree start. It had some shaky things about it because there were lots of earthquakes in those days, especially the third floor of Newkirk Hall. I have seen the walls of the hall move, and I was on the third floor, and I knew every part of the third floor. I had a little problem with water because I didn't. I had gone to a local swimming area to learn to swim, and I had some fears of water, and I knew what it was to be a chronic seasick, but I never let it get me down.
The name of the ship.
Yeah, what was the name of the ship?
USS Vogelgesang.
USS what?
Vogelgesang, which is a German admiral's name.
What kind of ship?
862 destroyer. It was one of the most advanced destroyers of the day. The reason I ended up there was because I couldn't. I was so tired of college. I was wanting something else. And I was encouraged to do something of what my roommate did. He had been a real heavy Baptist with from an Eastern college in Texas. I had grown up at Texas Tech. He was a very, very different as far as background is concerned, because he grew up he knew the campus of this Eastern College far better than I knew the campus of Texas Tech. And he was a Baptist background, a fundamental Baptist background. I grew up in the largest Methodist church in Lubbock, Texas. And I had the pastor of the largest Methodist church pastor. This guy had been in the service. And he could tell good jokes. He He had many stories to tell. I didn't have much respect for him in many senses because I had a background from another Methodist that was very different from him. This other Methodist, the first time I saw him when I returned from the service, he said, "Bill, I hear you've been converted." First thing he said, "Dick Soderberg, you can tell from his name that he was not local, except for the fact that he graduated with honors from the one of the best high schools in California. Guess how he spent every summer? Taking a guy fishing. Because he knew well a certain guy who was worked in a lumberyard, was the best spitter you ever saw, and had a language to go with it, named Dawson Trotman. Dick's mother was knew the scripture quite well. His father didn't. And one of the first things that he did with me was, I met him through my roommate because my roommate met him in the chow hall of Newkirk Hall. And so I got my first introduction to him through this roommate. He came up one evening after being down in the chow hall, which was the study hall for Newkirk Hall. And he said, "I met a guy today that you need to meet." I said, "What was he like?" He said, "The first thing I noticed was he had a Bible laying on his desk." This was Dick Soderberg. He had memorized many portions of Scripture. And he said the first question I asked him was, "What are you doing with the Bible on your desk?" "At a college." He said, "Why shouldn't I have a Bible on my desk? He found out right away from Dick Soderberg that Dick Soderberg was well schooled in Scripture. He had memorized many portions of Scripture. I had a father that had memorized a lot of Scripture. And his background was Baptist, from the plains of West Texas. And right away, he introduced me to Dick Soderberg. Dick said, "I have a Bible study up on the roof of the dormitory, which is carried on right after supper, right after we have chow." And he said to Dick, you'd be invited to go. At that time, there were three people in our dormitory, in our school area, and they were all engineers. Every type of engineer that you have was in that particular dormitory area. Dawson Trotman was a tobacco chewing, spitting character that knew lots of scripture. And we were both invited to come to that course. And I said to him, "Well, we have nothing else to do in the evening. We might go sometime. But we don't want it to interfere with our college. We don't want it to interfere with anything." And we didn't let it. We don't let it interfere with our special delight in ice cream. Nothing. We both continued going to church regularly. We got interested in a particular Methodist church that was solid. And the pastor of that church was a good teacher of the Word of God. So one Sunday we'd go to a Methodist church, next Sunday we'd go to a Baptist church, etc. And we didn't let any denomination interfere with mm-hmm. what we wanted to do. We visited a lot of different ones. You could go any place in Los Angeles without a bus, without transportation problems. All you had to do was step out on the curb of any corner in LA and tell them which way you wanted to go. And so we visited Methodist churches, we visited Baptist churches, we visited some that were sort of independent. Our roommate got sent to jail because he wrote in a letter obscene things about the captain of the base at USC. And we visited him at that institution. Because of my dad's interest, I'm sure, who was very interested in books and read to us from books. Jack London and the exciting news about what he wrote. He was a good reader. He had a lot of interest in reading and read all kinds of literature. He had a very godly father who was from the northeast. Erie. In that area.
Of Texas or of the U.S.?
U.S.
Okay.
He was married to his second wife because his first wife died before they were married too long. And Dad was the oldest twin of ten children. And all of them ended up settling in West Texas. Dick visited me that day when John Mark Galloway, wasn't there, my roommate. And the first, before you knew it, he had introduced me to the first book of the Navigators and the memorization possibilities there. And probably that day was the first day that I had ever memorized any scriptures. I knew a lot of scripture. I didn't get it from the Methodist Church as such. I got it from Sunday school. That's where I got it from. Before the morning was over, when we were together, I had invited the Lord into my life. I told that pastor at the First Methodist Church Lubbock, the Cathedral of the Plains, if you please. I told him, and he even asked me if I'd ever thought about being a pastor. I said yes, but I didn't. I didn't know enough about the Bible, and I felt like I needed to. But I knew plenty about church, I guarantee you. And sat next to my father. Mother was a Methodist. My father grew up in a country Baptist church. But guess who had more training along church lines? My mother did. And was a strong Methodist. She was baptized by immersion, like all Methodists in those days. Are you kidding? I was the first man to be kicked out of officer school, officer's college. And I didn't have the worst grades there. But I got kicked out without ever failing to go on liberty on the weekend. I didn't miss liberty.
Some things are more important.
Oh, many, many things are much more important.
So fast forward to Operation Frostbite.
All right. I had to get out of the midshipman school. I had to get out of the officer training school. I had to be sent to a school close to Chicago because I failed to keep up my studies. I was tired of college. I was fed up with it. And so I got, when I got kicked up, kicked out, they found out my interest in lights of the Navy. And I was sent right away to to end up being a quartermaster. And the captain kind of took a liking to me. After 5 weeks at in New York City at the by the way, I taught a Bible class at I taught two Bible classes.
On the ship or in Chicago?
In Chicago.
Okay.
I questioned a lot of the captain's judgments regarding all the things they ask quartermasters, and disagreed with him on a number of them. And he was always glad to see that I didn't necessarily agree with him. He'd grown up on a river in Germany on a destroyer in Germany.
Did he name the destroyer then? How come he ended up captaining a destroyer with a German admiral's name?
I think it had something to do with it. I don't know that.
Okay.
When I got aboard ship, that's what made the difference as to which way I was headed, because I got on a ship that was a brand new destroyer, and whenever I disagreed with the captain on his judgments about things, he would question me, and many times find I was right. I ended up on with about four or five other destroyers, and we had on our ship a upper officer who made the rules about lots of things. And he said, "You don't have to shave." Guess what I did just before you came over? Certainly. For all the weeks that you're on this submarine. Not submarine, but you brought that up all ago.
Destroyer, yeah.
All the weeks that you're on this expedition of Frostbite. And I hadn't shaved for about a week or so before he got aboard. And I grew up full beard. I grew up full bearing. Never had in my life before then. And we were going to spend every night traveling to a different country. The only two countries were Greenland and Labrador.
I just went back and forth.
Back and forth. And I saw lots of icebergs and so forth. And things were slowing down in the Pacific. And Truman was about to step into his position. And by the time we returned from Greenland and Labrador, and we're on our way to the south. I found out about the South quite a bit. And I didn't become a quartermaster when I graduated. I was just sent aboard ship, and I was the up-and-coming quartermaster. And knew that I wasn't headed for the Navy. Knew I was a chronic seasick. Ate lots of cough drops. And ate some of my meals several times, but I never let it get me down.
And the North Atlantic can be pretty brutal.
And that particular section of the North Atlantic could be beautiful. With the color of the water. And
I wonder how close you were to where the Titanic went down 30 years prior.
I don't know. No. I don't know. I knew every place that the Volkswagen was. I was the one who kept up with the chronometers on that Volkswagen. I read them every week. And I knew the ship well. I could go any place in the ship. But I never let that seasick thing get in the way. I just threw up and ate another meal, and threw up and ate another meal. Just kept going. Thank God for a driving captain who didn't let me settle down. I could mock him and his North Carolinian language, his dialect. All right. You're a Texan. You're not from North Carolina. I'm just repeating your request.
In the way he said it.
In the way he said it. I knew as soon as I got out of the service, I was headed for Dallas Theological Seminary. knew it. And that's it. I didn't know what I'd be after that. I never thought about the fact that I might be a pastor.
God opened some big doors.
For oh, you. Yeah.
Bill, did you want to thank the church for all their support through your chaplaincy?
Sure. Always. I was pushing the chaplaincy. I was the first one with good news to leave the area of
Arlington.
Where the headquarters of the mission,
Virginia,
was located. Of course, I couldn't be in the shadow of Bill Simmer, who was the president and founder of Dallas Theological, because he was perfect and I wasn't.
Nobody's perfect.
Well, I knew that. I knew that.
How do you live in the shadow of Evelyn then? Because she's perfect and you aren't.
No,
in a different way.
Entirely. Afraid I'm not perfect.
Yeah, no, no.
Why do you think I was 45 years a chaplain?
Because you have a godly wife supporting you and encouraging you.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I'm blessed with 22 years for us that God's given me a precious wife.
We're a little ahead of you. We've been married 68 years.
Yep. You've got me beat. more than three times longer.
Well, you keep going and you'll make it too. Lord, I'd rather have the rapture come though, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I'd like to go together.
That's what we're
look to go together.
We're wanting to see.
Yeah. Well, even so, come Lord Jesus. It could be
could be
any time. The world has never been more ready for him to return.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you for your time. I appreciate you letting me come in and set up the cameras and things.